loop of a number or a number again and again, it is called repeated addition. Here you can see some rings. We make group of four rings. Rings के हमने four के groups बनाए हैं. हर group में four rings हैं. अब हमें इन्हें add करेंगे. First group में हमारे पास एक ही group है और कितने हैं उसमें rings? Four. That means we have four rings in how many groups? One. So how much rings we have? Four. In second group we have two group and each is having four rings in it. That means four and how many groups? Two. So how much we get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means four rings ke two group makes 8 rings. Now here we have three groups and four rings ke three group hai. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So four rings ke three group kya banate hai? 12. The next is four rings and four groups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. That means four rings, four groups is equal to 16. This is known as repeated addition. Repeated addition is also known as multiplication. This is the sign of multiplication. So multiplication is an easier way to count things. जब हमारे पास सारे नंबर सेम हो और हमें उन्हें ऐड करना हो तो मल्टीप्लिकेशन उसके लिए एक इजी वे है. इसीलिए हम मल्टीप्लिकेशन को रिपीटेड एडिशन भी कहते हैं.
नो अबाउट व्हाट इज मल्टीप्लिकेशन. मल्टीप्लिकेशन आल्सो हैज थ्री पॉसिबल एग्जांपल्स. 3 × 2 आंसर वी गेट 6. हियर 3 इज नोन एज मल्टीप्लिकेशन, 2 is known as multiplier and 6 is known as product. So it means multiplication has three parts: multiplicate, multiplier and product. After that we have some keywords of multiplication. First is times, double, groups of, multiply, all together. Whenever you see these keywords, it means our question is based on multiplication. In this class, we have to learn these three topics. First is properties of multiplication. Second is larger number of multiplication. Third is multiplication by 2 and 3 digits numbers.
Now, let's start multiplication's properties. Here we have four properties. First is commutative properties. You can always multiply numbers in any order and the product will be the same. If you multiply 5 into 4, we get 20. Yeah, we multiply 4 into 5, we always get 20. It means the product does not change even if the order change. Next is property of 1. When one of the factors is 1, the product equals the other number. For example, if we multiply any number to 1, we get number itself, like 5 into 1 equals to 5. Ya phir next example, 412 is multiplied by 1, we get 412. Associative properties. In these properties, you can group factors differently and the product will be the same. For example, if we have 2 and more than 2 numbers to multiply, it does not make any changes in the product. Let us see the example. Here we have 3 numbers to multiply, 4, 4 and 2. Now 4 into 4. If we multiply first two numbers, we get 16 as an answer because 4 into 4 is equals to 16. Now we multiply 16 into 3 numbers, which is 2. So we get 32 as an product. If we multiply last two numbers, which is 4 into 2. So, we get 8 as an answer. Now, we multiply 8 into first number, which is 4. So, we get 32 as an answer. It means you can group factors differently and the product will be the same. Now, last property is zero property. When one factor is zero, the product is zero. It means the product of a number and zero is always zero. If you multiply any number to zero, we get zero. Here is an example. 8 into 0, we get 0.